Hello and welcome to session one about Google Classroom. Thank you for joining us. In this session, we will learn how students can join Google Classroom, how students can check their emails, how to receive updates from your child's teacher via Google Classroom. It's known as Guardian Summaries. We'll also learn a few tips and tricks and learn about Cami and EdPuzzle and how your child will interact with them. We'll now take a look at Google Classroom and how a student can join a specific class or classes in Google Classroom. Well, what is Google Classroom? Google Classroom is a platform that enables teachers to create an online classroom area in which they can communicate with their students as well as manage documents that their students need. These documents are stored in Google Drive and can be edited in Drive's apps, such as Google Docs, Sheets, Slides, etc. Well, how can students join a class in Google Classroom? There are a few ways, and I'll show them to you. One way, students will need to enter into the Methacton Launchpad, also known as Class Link, and select Google Classroom. They will then need to enter in a code that is unique to their class. That code will have been provided by the teacher. You'll need to select the plus in the upper right and type in the code. So I'll show that to you right here. So I've entered into Methacton.org. And I'm going to select MyMSD, also known as the star. Now students will need to enter in their username, not their email address. And then they'll need to enter in their password. Which time you'll then need to enter in or select the launchpad. Now, if you want to take those first few steps out, what you could do is if you're in Chrome, select the three dots and then select bookmarks and then bookmark this tab. You could also select Control D, select Done, and a bookmark will be right here. Now I'm gonna right click and delete this. Another tip is you could highlight this whole link and then left click, hold down, and drag it down and place it here. And if you'd like, you could right click again, edit, and just call this Launchpad or whatever you'd like to name it. Then the student will need to enter in username and password and select sign in. You will then see Class Link, again, also known as the Launchpad, and select Google Classroom. And when they do so, they can select the plus in the upper right to join a class, and then type in that specific class code that was provided to them by their teacher, and then select Join. Now, I'm not going to do that right now. What I am going to do is show you the way that, for the most part, it will come up. Is the student will need to enter in, and then they'll see this where they can just join right away. So they can select join, and then they are in the classroom. Give it a few seconds, and it will then load. The last way was one in which the teacher will have emailed the student to join, and at which point they would just need to click on the link, and they would automatically be added. So there you go. In the next one, we'll take a look at how students can go ahead and check their email, as well as how parents can view Google Classroom Guardian summaries. Thanks for watching. Take care. Bye. In this example, we're going to take a look how students can check their email, as well as a quick tour of Google Classroom, what it looks like from a student's point of view. So we're in the Methacton Launchpad, also known as Class Link. You can make sure you're signed in by selecting right up in here, and you can see the student's name. Now, if you just type in Gmail, you'll see right in here that there have been some maybe assignments or questions or announcements that have been posted by a teacher or teachers. Now, students can go ahead and select right in here if they'd like to and see the question right away. They don't necessarily need to go into Google Classroom, although they could. So if they select here, they could go ahead in, open it up, and answer the question right away. So again, this is just a question here. So we're going to open it up. It's going to take us directly to the question. It says, what is your favorite color? And it lets you know right over in here to type your answer. Now, you'll see a place for class comments. Class comments would be open, where the student would put the question in there, and everyone in the class would be able to see the question that is there. Now, if it's just an answer that we're going to put in here, so let's just type in blue, we're going to select turn in, won't be able to make changes with this. So we go ahead, we turned it in, and that has now been completed. Now, you'll notice over here, if we go back to our Gmail, that there have been some other announcements. There's an announcement and there was an assignment. So let's go ahead back into, let's just go into Google Classroom this way, just so you can see. It is good to check your email just to see if there are any new announcements or things like that posted. However, I'll show you another way you can check some things. So you can see right in here, it says that there is something that is due coming up. It's due Friday. It's a favorite book. Of course, the student could go ahead and select right in here. If they'd like to, they could go directly there. Or they could select the classroom. And then they can see an announcement. Again, announcements are typically, as it says, they're kind of the social hub. It's where things are going to be posted by the teacher. Students, if enabled by the teacher, are able to go ahead and ask questions or post comments in here. Sometimes the ability to comment is removed for the whole class, just because right in here, it is just a nice clean way for teachers to make announcements. Of course, there are ways for students to reach out to the teachers. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead in here, and you can see that there is something upcoming. So it's a quick and easy way to see what is due. Another way you can do it is go into classwork, and you can see right in here, we've already finished this. It's why it's grayed out. There's nothing due. However, there is something due coming up, and we're going to select view our work. So right in here, their favorite book is assigned and it is due August 21st. See things from before. Maybe something is missing, some things that have been turned in. Just a nice way to go back in and see what has been turned in or see what is missing. So what I can do is go ahead into this and select favorite book and select view details. And now here's a question. What's your favorite book you've ever read and why? Again, you could post a class comment in here. Right over in here, a private comment. A private comment goes directly to the teacher. Other students would not be able to see it. Now, you need to add some work. So what you'll need to do is select Add or Create. And then you have your options in here, what you would like to add or create. In this case, we're going to include a Google Doc. Make sure to give it a little bit of time for the Google Doc to be created. Then you'll need to go ahead and select it right in here. If you'd like to add more than one Google Doc, you could certainly do that. But you can select right here to go into this Create a Google Doc. Now you notice the student's name will come up here, as well as the name of the assignment. And then I'm just going to put this right in here. Just going to put in sample. Now, if this has been completed and student is ready to go, you can select Turn In right here. Or you could select Turn In here. Again, it's automatically saved. If you'd like to, you can go ahead and select Turn In. It will let you know, hey, do you want to turn this in? You're going to select Turn In again. It will then go from green to gray. It's been submitted. If you'd like to take it back for whatever reason you're working on it, you can just use the unsubmit right there. But again, it's been turned in. And a way to check real quickly, make sure everything is ready to go and turned in and there's nothing due, is just to select classwork, and you can see what is due, what has already been turned in. Over here on the left-hand side, you can see topics. So it might be math, language arts, science, social studies, so on and so forth. So you can go ahead and select these certain items and see, hey, this has already been turned in. We're good. Week 5 learning, maybe it's things that were worked on in the past, so you can go through and check those things out as well. Maybe some old material. The people, I just want to show you this here. They're just the other classmates that are in the classroom. So there you go. That is a brief tour of Google Classroom. Thank you so much for watching. In this tutorial, we're going to take a look at EdPuzzle. So what is EdPuzzle? It's a web-based interactive video and formative assessment tool that lets users crop existing online videos and add content to target specific learning objectives. So what's that look like? Let's go ahead and take a look. So a couple quick things. Once the student is logged in, again, they can go into Gmail and see that there has been a new assignment posted, so they can go ahead in and select it. Again, it's something to get used to going in and checking email, so they can go ahead, select here, and then open the assignment right here. Another way to do this is to go into the Launchpad, select Google Classroom, and then you'll see the tile, the specific classroom. You can see this right here, and you can see that there is an assignment due Friday. So of course they can select here. They can also go ahead in, select classwork. They can see there's been a new one here. But the main thing you really want to check is view your work. So you can see things that are assigned, turned in, and missing. Again, it's right here, EdPuzzle, and it's on characterization. So we're going to go ahead and select that, and then select view details. Now, you can see we're going to have to select right in here. Now, there may be times where this is worth a certain number of points. Sometimes it's ungraded. It depends on the teacher. For right now, I have it at 100 points. We're going to select right in here. And now you can see how there are things that are coming up to do. Now, I'm not going to go through all this, but I just want to show you what it's going to look like. So I'm going to go ahead and play it.
Characterization is the way that the writer reveals the personality of a character. Even though this is a literary term, we can demonstrate its use using the movie Frozen.
Okay, so you can see little notes that they're going to ask them to. So if there's something like, hey, you need to copy down the definition of characterization, if they know it, they can go ahead and write it in. If they need to rewatch it, they can rewatch it, and then they know that they have to write this down. So let's go ahead and rewatch it.
Characterization is the way that the writer reveals the personality of
the character. Okay, so they can go ahead and pause it and write it down.
Even though this is a literary term, we can demonstrate its use using the movie Frozen.
Okay, we're going to go ahead and hit continue.
Characters are revealed through direct characterization and indirect characterization. Direct characterization tells the audience what the personality of the character is.
Okay, so if we have that and we know that, we can go ahead and select continue after we've written our notes.
A great example of this is, the patient boy and the quiet girl were both well-mannered and did not disobey their mother. Here, the author is directly telling the audience the personality of the two children. The boy is patient, and the girl is quiet.
Okay, so you can see right in here, here's our multiple choice question. So you can go ahead, which words in the quote does the author use to directly characterize the boy and the girl? So if they need to rewatch it, they can go ahead and rewatch it. So
a great example of this here is, we go. The patient boy and the quiet girl were both well-mannered and did not disobey their mother. Here, the author is directly telling the audience the personality of the two children.
Okay.
The boy is patient, and the girl is quiet.
So there we go. So we can go ahead. Patient and quiet. And then you can continue on. And you want to hit submit. Okay. So there we go. So far, so good. We're going to hit continue.
Characters will also be revealed.
Okay. So they will go through. Now, depending on how the teacher does have things set up, for the most part, they're going to have to go through the whole thing and they won't be able to skip ahead. Sometimes on certain ones, depending on the teacher and how they have the lesson set up, they may be able to skip, but for the most part, they're going to have to watch the whole thing and answer questions as it goes through. So that's how they'll go through, work on EdPuzzle, and then make sure at the very end, when they're finished with everything, to make sure they'll hit mark as done to make sure that it is completed once they have completed the entire assignment. So there you go. Thank you so much for watching. Take care. Bye-bye. In this tutorial, we're going to take a look at a few tips and tricks that may help students. So the first one here is logging on to Methacton's website, which you can always select right in here, the MyMSD has the star, and students can log in right here. So it's a quick, easy way to go ahead in and sign in. However, something to point out is here's the launch pad. You can see that right in here, that moving forward, the applications below are now going to become available in class link, which is this right here. So if we go ahead in and select that, students will need to go ahead in and sign in again. So we're going to sign in and the launch pad will come up. So something I would recommend is to go ahead and bookmark this. So students can go ahead in and They could just select right over here and say bookmark this tab or use Control D. They can rename it right away. So if they just want to call it Launchpad, they can do that. Of course, it can always be changed later on as well. You can see it's just Launchpad. If they know that that is a Launchpad, you can always right click, edit. You don't have to have a name on there. If you know that that's a Launchpad right there, you can have a number of these bookmarks up here. Another one I'd recommend is quickly having Gmail available. It's something to make sure that students go ahead in and check, I would say pretty much every day, to see what is going on and what is going to be asked of them. So if they go ahead, they can also drag this down. You can right click, edit, and if they know that's Gmail, they can remove all that and select save, and then they can select right in here. Now, another thing with bookmarks, if they'd like to, they can right click in here, and then what they could do is they could go ahead in and they could add a folder. So if they wanted to call it, let's just say school for right now, we could call this school, and then they could drag certain bookmarks over if they'd like to and drop it in, and you can see it's right here. Of course, you can always move it back out if you'd like to, and right click, rename, delete, so on and so forth. So something to know. Now, something that happens a lot is sometimes tabs get closed. So let's say we close that one and we're like, oh my gosh, I didn't want to close those out. I want that back. So how can you do that? You can hold down Control, Shift, T, and it brings back that previous tab. Let's do this one as well. So it brings it back right away. So it's ready for you. So that's a nice thing to have. Now, another one to show you is right over in here. It's a three dots. This is how you can customize and control Google Chrome. So you may be asked sometimes to go ahead in and open up a new tab. You can see these shortcuts come over here as well. There's also the history, downloads, bookmarks. You can zoom in or out. You can print. You can also go into settings. So if you're ever asked to go into settings, just go into the three dots, go into settings, and then you can scroll down and see the options that are available. Of course, you can just close out of it right here as well. Another quick one is if a student knows that they, or if anyone knows and they're logged into Google, that they'd like to start a new document. Instead of going into, of course, they could always go into Google Drive. And when they go into Google Drive, you can just select New. And then you have your options here for Docs, Sheets, Slides. Now, something to come up here. There's also more. There's Google Forms and Drawings and so on and so forth, Google Sites. However, if you know you want to start a new doc right away and you're not in Google Drive, what you can do is you can just type in doc.new. And right away, a new document comes up. Just be sure to name it. So if I was going to say, sample, this is always something nice to know, is it will take your first sentence or first few words. If you click up here, it just names it according to that right there. Items like this will come up. Once you understand it, you can just select got it, and there you go. So that's a nice one to have. Another one, just to point out, just as a reminder, and let's go into Launchpad again, is with Google Classroom. Can't say this enough about going in and making sure to check email just to see what assignments are coming up. However, going into Google Classroom, it's nice to see what any announcements, anything that's due. For example, I can see right away that something's due right here. I can also go ahead in and I can select the classwork. And when I select classwork, I can see items that have been posted. I can see the topics over here as well. But the main one I want to point out right in here is view your work. So if I select view your work, you can see items that have been assigned, items that have been turned in, and items that are missing. So of course you can always go ahead in and see them and view any details that are needed. But that is really an important one to point out, is going ahead in, classwork, view your work. So there you go. Those are just a few tips and tricks just to share with you. Thank you so much for watching. I hope this has helped. Take care. Bye-bye.